Hello and welcome to a new video. Today's video will be a studio tour or like a workspace kind of video. I've done a video like this I think about 2 years ago now and it looks totally different, and yeah, I think it was time to make a new one. So here it is and I hope you enjoy. Alright, so this is the door to my studio, and on my door I have this little painting that my friend made, and I still love it so much. I think pigeons are so cute, they're one of my favorite birds actually. So when you come into my room, this is kind of an overview of what you see. It's really hard to show how tiny this room is. I mean, it's big enough for a little studio, but it is pretty tiny. On this side of the room, I have this little cabinet or highboard. I don't know what you call them exactly, but it's from the 60s and I bought it secondhand. And it's also a second desk, which is really handy. I used to store all my Etsy stuff in it, but then I realized that there are easier ways to store your Etsy stuff. And yeah, I will show you later in this video. On top of it, I have my record player with all my records on the side. And I really like the way it looks. And then next to my record player I have my yellow typewriter, which you can't really see because my monstera is massive. He is making so many new leaves at the moment because it's spring and you know, that's what plants do, but yeah, I don't really know where to put him when he gets any bigger, so that's gonna be an issue, but for now it's fine. And then on the wall I have my electric guitar and my ukulele, and there is a new leaf. It's kind of hard to open, especially with one hand, because it is old, you know. Okay, so inside I have all my art supplies. In here I have some things I use when I do oil painting, like mediums and also things to prepare wood for. Then in here I have things I don't really use actually, but I don't want to get rid of. It's mostly inks, dip pens and also some oil pastels. Next to that I got my brushes. In here I got all my gouache. In the box underneath it I got all my oil paints, which are by Gambling. I really like them. And in those two boxes I have paper and sketchbooks and stuff, which is really worth showing. So yeah, there I have my radio, and in the box I have some CDs. Drawer, I've got all my most used art supplies, so like all the watercolors I use, and also a little palette I use for my gouache. I use this one the most, it's by Winsor & Newton, and I think like everyone has it. And then in there I've got some color pencils and an envelope. Yeah, just some pencils. I only use my color pencils, which are on the top. In here I have things that I don't really use much. In those two boxes I have things for printmaking. Basically the rest is markers, which I never use, and also my acrylic paints, which I do use occasionally, but also not too much, so I stuffed it all in the back. And this side actually doesn't open, which kind of sucks, but yeah. And then there's my bin. So then I have this blue chest of drawers. I actually bought it secondhand and I painted it blue myself. And then next to that I've got my desk. But yeah, I painted it myself and I really like the outcome. On top I have my scanner, which I bought last year, and it's dusty. I'm so sorry. I should have cleaned before filming this video. But yeah, it's the Canon 9000F Mark II. And it is a really good scanner. I really like it. I use it a lot, actually. A lot more than I thought I would use it. And the cool thing about this scanner is that it can scan film as well. You have to take this white thing off and then light comes in from above, which makes it able to scan in film. And then next to it I've got this Sloth money box, I think it's called. I got it for my birthday from my sister. And then I have a little beetle and also this plant, which is getting huge. All my plants are like growing so fast and I don't really have the space for like really big plants, so... And in this chest of drawers, I actually store all my stuff for my Etsy store. And I love it so much, like it's one of the best things I bought this year. Because I used to store all my Etsy stuff in the cabinet I just showed you, but it really wasn't working for me. And yeah, I didn't really have space to make lots of products, and yeah, this is so much better. But yeah, I basically have all my prints in here. I have all my stickers, and I do have a lot of them, so... Also, this moth is so big, like I really should check how big things are before I order them, because it was so much bigger than I thought it would be. But yeah, I really like it though. And then this one is empty, and that one as well, because I'm making more stickers and I'm keeping them free for more stickers. So in here I have some like printmaking prints. And in that one I have all my tote bags. I really want to make more, by the way, but it's quite a bit of work. And then in here I have some things I use for shipping, like little thank you cards and stickers I always put on the order. And these little thank you cards I hand printed myself. And then I always write a little note on the back. So lots of things I don't really know what to do with. Then I have lots of freebies in here, because I don't want to send those because they have like a little mistake in them or whatsoever, so I'll keep them in here. And then I have all my shipping stuff in here, like envelopes and tissue paper. And in this box I've got all my plastic, which I don't really want to use anymore, but I'm using all this up and then I'm gonna switch to biodegradable plastic. Then I have my desk, also from the 60s, I'm pretty sure, and I also got it secondhand. I have a little plant on top with my most used pens and brushes, and then my computer, some water to drink. And I cleared this out yesterday, so it is looking really tidy. It's normally not like this, but I've barely got anything in here. Just packaging tape, pencil case, a round corner punch, and some tissues I always use when I'm painting and I don't want to walk to the kitchen. In the back I have some paintings and two sketchbooks I use the most. Then in here I've got all my electronics, mainly just my camera and camera stuff, but also like my iPod and some headphones. And in here I've got nothing except for my tablet and my iPad. I have a really old iPad. I think it's an iPad 1, and a lot of apps don't even work anymore, but I do use it sometimes. And then I have this tablet which I recently got, and I absolutely love it. I usually put my computer in there when I want to have more space on my desk, so that's why I keep it so empty. On this side I have my lamp with a little candle, and I think I bought my chair in a charity shop, but I'm sure it's from IKEA. And in here I have lots of notebooks, which I don't really use actually, and also an agenda and stuff, but yeah, I don't really use them. And a little thing to cut paper. And here I store all my film cameras and things that have to do with film cameras, also my headphones, and then the things I need for my scanner to scan in film. Then there's my window, and then I have my piano, which I am actually thinking of selling, because I really don't play anymore. Like, it does take up a lot of space, but at the same time, I've had this piano since I was like 15, and it's like really mine. So, and yeah, on top I have my enormous Calathea, also for this one. I really don't know where to put it when it gets any bigger, because it is growing so fast. And then there I have some little dried flowers I got from a friend. And then there I have some more plants, basically. So yeah. Oh, and on the floor I have this rug, which I got from my dad 4 years ago, I think. And that's basically my room. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe if you haven't yet. That would mean a lot to me, because it really helps my channel. And I'll see you next time. Bye!